Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.
Now we're going to throw another one in there, because that one's a good one. Lil Wayne now.
Okay.
Now I'm gonna tell you what I got your bomb money ready. This is what I seen people say. And tell me if I'm right or wrong.
I'm on the outside looking in.
Yeah, you done told the story. Now you really kind of in. This ain't nothing bad. This ain't nothing wrong. You told the story of how you stood up for them. They was on the grape side of it.
Right.
Right. This the internet, so a boy say, man, I know you seasoned brother, you thinking back to a year. Hey, man, maybe you right on the year, maybe wrong on the year.
I'm going to stop you right there, man.
Go ahead.
I'm going to fucking stop you in your tracks right there, then, man. Fuck all that shit, because I don't do the
was
shit.
Was your year right?
No.
Your year
and
was
I
wrong.
Went back on and made another video and re-innovated it. Same. Listen, homie, listen, TV Land. First, what I'm not going to do.
We gonna believe.
Ain't none of you niggas gonna ever put me in no spot on this internet and say, well, Big Cap, you was a lie. You
don't
lie.
Give me no lie vibe.
Yeah, I ain't no motherfucker.
You don't
liar,
give me
homie.
Lie vibes.
Now, I speak fast because I'm adamant and I'm really truthful I'm passionate about this shit. Yeah. So, yeah, I speak fast, bro. So, what I did when I was telling the Lil Wayne story, I fucked my year up.
Yeah, it's cool.
For me, I said 92, and this was during the time when I did the peace treaty, and we were still in peace. But it's like 97, 96, when this nigga was like 15, 16 years old. Not then, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So when I realized
you know the internet shit.
Right.
As soon as you say something, like, it's over with.
But this is how sharp I am about it.
Yeah.
I seen that. When I went back on, I seen comments, and then my phone rung. I said, oh, goddamn, that was right, man. Oh, I said 92 because I know that was my year. I was doing all my good shit when the Peace Treaty started. So, here's the bottom line to ask the Lil Wayne question, homie. My first encounter with Lil Wayne and them, bro, because I had two encounters.
What year was it? 96?
96, 97.
Yeah,
bro.
Cool.
The same year that Drop It Like It Hot came out and they was promoting that album. They was going around in their vans and touring and shit. They was really going hard.
Drop It Like It's Hot. Oh, what's the name of that day?
With Juvenile, they was the group Lil Wayne, the Hot Boys.
Yeah, talking about all the money and
so
all the
they
cars.
Was on,
yeah.
They was at the, when they came in the game. They was fucking with the Jordan Downs, Lil Petey Roll and them, my nigga.
Yeah,
they got introduced to Watts through Petey Roll, bro. Petey Roll was
ripping the set now.
Let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
They was listen
anxious for this one.
Yeah, it wasn't so much as them repping it, because they wasn't involved just yet.
Mm.
But they was wearing the colors. They was wearing purple, my niggas.
Showing love.
Well, you call it
having love. Having love.
Listen, you can call it showing love all the fuck you want, however you want to sugarcoat it. For the gray streaks, nigga, they was reeling them niggas in.
Yeah.
And if they would have stayed, they would have been fucking gray streaks.
Mm.
Instead, when Mac got a hold to him. That's when they got introduced to the Damu aspect, which they was already seeing both sides of it.
Shout out to homie Mac that I just got off the phone with, not even.
Yeah, that's my ninja.
Yeah.
Feel me? So when Mac went down there, Mac was what really
Mac 1-0.
Introduced them and gave them the flavor, man. You feel me? And that's what, so my whole thing was this. When I seen Lil Wayne, BG, and Lil Turk, they was in the record store with a Mexican bodyguard. There's two bodyguards. My whole thing was I was already in the Jordan Downs. Bro. I just got through gambling with the niggas and I was smoking weed and I just got some weed. So I'm in the parking lot and I'm ear hustling. I heard the Baby Lokes talking about the niggas in the record store doing the signing. That's how I got wind of it. I
lining them up.
Yeah, they made it line that ass up.
Yeah.
Finna go get them. Fuck Peter Roy and them, because this is another squad out of the projects that don't care. These the hungry wolves.
Yeah.
So the wolves about to go get them.
Yeah.
I said, who the hot boy? Now, my thing was, I had just started Paper Chase Entertainment, my independent label. So, I was one of the biggest independent companies that was hot in Watts at that time. I was becoming a competition to my little homeboy OFTB and them.
Mm-hmm.
So, I had signed cast out of Jordan Downs, PJs, each project, I had a coalition of them there. I got Bounty Hunters, Crips, Bloods, Mona Parks. I got them on my label. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
We were under peace at Watts. So I was trying to teach all these young niggas how we bridge this shit and bring it together, get money, we eat. So we was doing our thing. When they came and surfaced, when Petey Roll and them bought them to Watson and everything, like I said, the youngsters and them planned to go rob them. That particular day, when I was down in Jordan Downs, I heard that. Immediately, I went to that record store, which is on 103rd, right across the street from the elementary store. It's a taco stand right next door to it now. The same very place is a laundromat right now today. You feel what I'm saying? So I went in there, and they was in there. And I seen him. I said, I walked right to him. I said, hey, man, who the manager? Who the road manager? Who the manager? Dude told pointed me to the kettle. I walked up to him. I said, hey, let me holler at you. I introduced him, told him. I said, I'm Buddy on the BJ. I'm from the Knicks to Gordon. I said, listen, man. I said, I got a little label called Paper Chase Entertainment. I just started my shit. I said, yeah, I just had to change my name because you niggas, man. We were CMBs, Cash Money Brothers. True story. So
hey, what made you pick that name?
New Jack City.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what they got them to.
Because I took the New Jack City formula to the projects when I seen the movie, and I was the first nigga that had multiple crack
yeah,
houses in my
projects.
They took
it to the rap game. So they took it to the rap game. You took it to the projects.
Took it to the projects, huh?
Okay, now I'm with you. I'm riding. I'm in the car.
Yeah, you stay with me. Yeah. Stay with me. So so look, now we in the record store, and I'm getting at him, and I tell him, I said, look, man, you need to get your boys and them up out of here, man. Young niggas is plotting to come get y'all, homie. Matter of fact, give me a number, get contact. Who run this shit? Who the head nigga? You know what I mean? So he gave me his number. I call him.
Who's him?
I'm trying to remember this cat name, man.
Don't say it if you don't remember.
Yeah,
we'll just,
yeah I was trying to remember his name, but he was their road manager at the time. Feel me? And so once I talked to him, they left, got on. My little just so happened, Juwie wasn't with them that day, but he was out in L.A. My little homeboy, how meaning them, was fucking with Juwie. This is how they was split up. So he had a connection with Juwie. Just coincidentally, he called me and tell me, big homie, I got the nigga Juwie on them number, man. They want to holler at you. So this is how I got plugged with Juwie. And me and Juwie became, you know what
tight.
I mean? Straight up A1. So that's how I started fucking with Juwie after the fact of that. But you know what I mean? Look, shoot, the dude right then on the spot looked out for me, took care of me, you know what I mean? Looked out and they got on, left, jumped in their little van, got on.
Yeah, we on Boss Talk 101.